फ्रेंड्स, क्रिप्टो ट्रांजैक्शंस के ऊपर एक फ्लैट 30% इनकम टैक्स प्रपोज किया गया है। तो जैसे ही 30% फ्लैट इनकम टैक्स रेट प्रपोज किया गया, देयर वाज अ ह्यूज डिस्कशन अराउंड वेदर एंड हाउ जीएसटी वुड बी लेवियबल ऑन दिस काइंड ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शंस। नाउ इन वन ऑफ द रिसेंट इंटरव्यू, मिस्टर तरुण बजाज हैज हाइलाइटेड दैट मिस्टर तरुण बजाज हैज स्पोकन विद द सीबीआईसी चेयरमैन एंड देयर इज डिस्कशन व्हिच इज हैपनिंग अराउंड लेवी ऑफ जीएसटी ऑन क्रिप्टो ट्रांजैक्शंस। So certainly it appears that the government is evaluating how crypto transactions would be levied or how GST would be leviable on crypto transactions. Friends, जब हम crypto transaction देखते हैं तो पहले हम समझते हैं कि ये type के transactions होते क्या है। Friends, आप सबको पता है कि Bitcoin is one of the example of crypto transactions. So if somebody is buying Bitcoin from a non-resident person, so the first question from GST perspective would be, will it qualify as import of services or will it qualify as import of goods? The second question would be that when you are selling this crypto money to someone else in India, let us say, then whether it will qualify as supply of goods or services in India. Now when you look at these kind of questions, various GST implications would follow on these kind of transactions. First, what is the rate of GST on these kind of transactions? Will they be taxed at a concessional rate? Say 5%, 12%, or for that matter even 18%, or will they attract a GST of 28%? Because you know that as far as the income tax is concerned, the government is saying that we don't want to even allow you to set off the income tax losses. So the government is not treating these transactions as a normal business transaction, but rather speculative transactions. And accordingly, the government trying to levy the highest possible income tax rate. Now similarly, will the government, even with respect to crypto transaction, levy a GST of 28%? That is one interesting question. Second important aspect is, when you are importing cryptos effectively, that is you are paying a non-resident to say procure certain bitcoins, now whether that transaction would qualify as import of service. Friends, if it does, then practically it will mean that irrespective of the fact as to what value of Bitcoin you are importing, or for that matter cryptocurrency you are importing, you will have to discharge GST liability, because for import of services there is no threshold or there is no basic exemption which is available. Then third important aspect would be, when somebody buys say crypto, a particular cryptocurrency for 100 and he is selling it for 120, how these kind of transactions would be subject to GST? One methodology could be that you are only levying GST on the margin, that is the profit which you are making. Second could be you are levying GST on the gross value and then you are allowing a set off of GST which is paid on procurement by you. And third would be that you would be levying GST on the gross value, but at the same time no set off would be allowed, no set off would be given. These three possibilities right now appear as far as GST is concerned. But as far as clarity on levying GST on crypto currency is concerned, all of you are aware, before any decision with respect to rate is taken on any particular goods or services, because यहाँ पर तो crypto goods है या services है, इसके बारे में एक debate है. Additionally, all of you are aware, there is a definition of money under section 2 sub clause 75 of GST Act. वहाँ पर ये भी debate होगा, discussion होगा as to whether the money transaction, because इसमें एक electronic remittance करके भी word है, whether cryptos will qualify as electronic remittance, and अगर वो electronic remittance उस term में आ जाता है तो certainly it will not qualify as goods or services. Additionally, आप सबको पता है schedule 3 में serial number 6 में एक specific mention है, that is about actionable claims. Will the government say that these transactions are basically actionable claims, or will the government say that these transactions are similar to betting, gambling and lottery, and accordingly the GST treatment will follow? So friends, we'll have to wait for at least 3 to 4 months for appropriate clarity to emerge. But if your organization is dealing into crypto, then certainly these 4 months could be very crucial for you, as you can utilize this time for making appropriate representation before the government. Because as far as the government is concerned, the CBIC is concerned, the GST Council is concerned, please note that this is the first time the GST department is going to talk about cryptos and levy GST on crypto. So certainly this is a new transaction for them. You will have to take appropriate efforts to ensure that appropriate clarity is passed on to the decision maker as far as crypto transactions are concerned. So we hope you are able to successfully represent these kind of cases before the GST Council and appropriate authority, and you get appropriate clarification in days to come on this issue. So with आई वुड से विद फिंगर्स क्रॉस्ड वी ऑल्सो वेट फॉर अप्रोप्रिएट क्लैरिफिकेशन इन डेज टू कम. सो वंस द क्लैरिफिकेशन इमर्जेस वी विल अगेन हैव अ डिस्कशन ऑन क्रिप्टो ट्रांजेक्शन. थैंक यू.